Alcohol is older than the Great Pyramid at Giza, Machu Picchu, the Roman Colosseum, the Taj Mahal, and the Great Wall of China combined. And while it is not considered one of the wonders of the world, maybe it should be. Hey everybody out there in drunk land, Trace here for DNews. Alcohol, or more accurately ethanol, is a simple enough chain of carbon and hydrogen with an oxygen thrown in for good measure. But it is most definitely humanity's favorite neurotoxin. Anywhere we've been, we make alcohol, or bring it with us. It's a social lubricant, it's liquid courage, and it's for some a constant companion. It just gets along with us so well. When ethanol enters the body, some leaches in through mucous membranes, but the lion's share of it travels through the stomach to the small intestine to be absorbed into the bloodstream. That's the goal. Ethanol is water-soluble, so once in the bloodstream, there's no stopping it. Like a drunk Westchester teen, it parties at every stop on the train to Drunktown. Skin and organ tissues, heart muscles, brain cells, alcohol pals it up with them all. In the brain, it binds with a molecule called glutamate, a neurotransmitter that normally keeps neurons excited so they can fire on all cylinders. Once bound, your brain slows as your neurons become less excited. It also activates GABA receptors. The famous GABA molecule is another neurotransmitter, and needless to say, since the receptors are active, the brain doesn't make more GABA. Without GABA, you feel calmer and sleepy. This continues until the liver is able to metabolize it out of the blood. No matter how you get the alcohol into your body, this long process is how you get drunk. Though, being human, we have obviously found new and horrifying ways to jump the line. Inserting drugs into the rectum, for example, has been done for millennia and was at one time a popular way to take tobacco. But still, don't try it. Alcohol enemas, what the hyped up media call butt chugging.
Butt chugging. You heard me right. Butt chugging. Chugging of the butt.
Bypasses the body's natural poison detection and metabolization systems, getting people way too drunk way too fast. It's super dangerous, y'all. Alcohol inserted into the body via an alcohol enema isn't processed by the digestive system and can cause alcohol poisoning and even death. Not to mention, if you do live, you can have anal pain, tenesmus, or the feeling of having to go a lot, and colonic bleeding. Vodka-soaked tampons are along this same vein, no pun intended, with the mucosal membranes becoming irritated and burning from alcohol contact. But that doesn't stop people from trying things. Oh no! Palcohol is a powder-like alcohol legalized in the US in March of 2015 and then very shortly thereafter banned in a lot of places. We talked about it on DNews. Remember that? No? Come subscribe so you don't miss it next time. Palcohol is made to be dissolved in water, but it could also be snorted, which is the worry that some legislators had, even though there doesn't seem to be much evidence that anyone other than one Vice reporter actually did it. The reason snorting it would make sense from a drunk's perspective is because you wouldn't have to wait the few minutes for the alcohol to hit the stomach and then the small intestine. The blood vessels in the nose are close to the skin, and if the ethanol is absorbable, then boom, direct line to the blood. Same as butt chugging and the vaginal tampon thing. Palcohol highly discourages this practice, and the description by the Vice reporter should discourage it too. Ouch. But if you're trying to get into the blood, why not go right to the source? That's what some people do. A 1999 Oxford Journal study looked into people who injected alcohol directly into their bloodstream. And although they didn't die, there was a lot of burning pain. Three case studies looked at people who admitted to injecting vodka, sherry, whiskey, and one guy even tried beer right into their blood. But they weren't the first. Victorians were also famous for getting crunk. A man named H.C. Dalton would inject whiskey, not ethanol, mind you, whiskey, under the skin of patients suffering from morphine poisoning. It was a treatment. This guy was mixing a deadly cocktail for sure. Of course, he wasn't trying to get the people drunk. It wasn't his first rodeo. He'd been using whiskey injections in the past to keep patients alive and kicking. Funny story, this was all described by the 1911 Montreal Medical Journal, and alcohol was listed as a stimulant, but it's not, it's a depressant, which gives a whole new meaning to doing a shot, doesn't it? And now the ultimate, breathable booze, has been invented. You don't need to inject, snort, butt chug, or even drink it. Instead, just breathe air that is in this bar in London called alcoholic architecture. When vaporized, alcohol is present in the air, and it intoxicates you via your lungs, because the blood vessel's there, your skin, blood vessel's there, and is even absorbed through your eyeballs. It bypasses the liver altogether, I think it does not need to be said, and we're going direct to the blood, and have we learned nothing from this video? What the hell, man? According to a doctor consulted by the Associated Press, this has the potential to cause serious side effects as well as brain damage in the developing young brain. They even make people wear ponchos so they don't absorb too much too quickly. Overall, a study of over 2,300 adults found innovative alcohol use extremely rare. Only 1.1% of people surveyed have ever done any of these things, and they included way weirder stuff too. So when you see it in the media, raise your glass and toast their hype. Maybe we should all just stick to drinking alcohol with our mouths the way it was intended, right? For more boozy fun, Julian looks into the urban legend that whiskey makes you fight, vodka makes you party, and tequila makes your clothes come off. So check that out here.
There's no reason vodka or gin or tequila or whiskey or wine or beer or absinthe should make you act differently, provided you're drinking the same amount of alcohol.
Thanks for watching D News, everyone. Subscribe so you get all of our videos every day, and we will see you next time.